This game is rated M by the ESRB.
Okay.
Any changes, Haru? Nothing, unfortunately. Father is still indisposed. How are things with you, Haru? Has anything happened with the media? I hope they haven't been horrible to you. Thank you. They will surely say a great deal about my father.
Society doesn't care what may be going on.
Why did
on
you
as
turn Haru into
to,
a fucking monster?
To kill their perpetual boredom. They don't even consider how their words may hurt others. Shut the fuck up. They think caring... God damn it.
Oh my
it's
god,
It's been so
Sky.
Long since I fucking voiced these characters. Think caring about people is someone else's job. Makes me want to puke.
There's nothing we can do about that, though. And everything they say about Father is true. But it's important to remember there was someone else in the shadows behind the shutdowns. Until we can bring their crimes to light, this won't end. We'll find the true culprit for sure.
Naturally.
Yeah, it's gonna be a hella good victory when we expose that criminal for who he really is. Either way, we'll need to wait for Haru's father to recover. We'll have plenty of time to ask him about it then. The one behind the mental shutdowns. It has to be someone dangerous. Now that we're getting closer to the truth, we need to be ready for absolutely anything.
I think we're about to hit the point in the game where the heroes hit their bottom.
What the
their
fuck?
Their rock bottom.
That's fucking gross.
You're dumb.
You're dumb. Yeah, you can go hang out with Tifum.
Tifum?
Part of me wanted to pick Ifumi too. She's a cute girl.
I expected you to pick Ifumi, actually. I thought that was going to be your choice.
She is fucking primo choice, I think, even if Fiddle likes her.
Who cares? She's actually a fine girl.
But she's good.
Thank you very much.
Rank 6.
Check.
Ha You have been defeated. The battlefield is mine. The ultimate Togo Kingdom is complete.
All my pieces have been taken. Ifumi has left me utterly defeated.
But to think you could stay standing after being struck by my silver infinity sword. What?
Excuse my typing, sir.
Considering that you endured the climbing silver so early in the match. The determination I'm sensing from you is a real inspiration. I must think of a new move. I'm afraid you'll surpass me one day if I don't stay sharp.
Actually,
the exhibition match against the pro my mother was talking about has been confirmed. He's a very famous shogi player. I'm aiming to be the first woman to reach the pro ranking league. I'm sure it will draw a lot of attention, especially after that article. However, I don't intend to lose. This is my chance to display my true skill. I confess, I am a bit scared though.
A 3.
May come down to luck.
You're right. However, that also means I have a chance of winning, even though my opponent is ranked higher. To be honest, I'm not sure how well my skills will hold up against a true professional.
All right.
But I'm sick of being treated like an idol. I have to show them what I'm made of.
Idols are cute too. They're cool too.
2.
I believe in you.
Thank you. So, there's a move I want to try out. Would you like to play another match?
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Strategically place your pieces in the enemy's zone to increase your chances of getting gold. Be sure to use that tactic in your next match. For today, try and steal the pieces you want from me.
This girl doesn't even matter anymore. Rank up.
No, she. What the fuck, dude? Rank him up, dude. Dude.
Earn double money if battle's won in dude. One turn after a successful ambush. That's pretty cool.
Also, our max rank is godlike, so you. Fuck yeah.
Oh, hell yeah. No, I'm gonna get this girl to max rank.
Well then, let's begin the match.
At least I hope I do.
You will.
I hereby place this golden mantle upon your shoulders. Don it with pride.
It's one of your priorities.
Come, lightning metamorphosis gold promotion!
That's fucking stupid.
Hey, I got knowledge of the man.
Oh man. Oh man, nice.
Alright.
You're already fucking Albert Einstein, so it doesn't
matter. Yeah, pretty much. I turn to see who the other genius is. It's Albert Einstein.
I fucking love it. Oh, that's so stupid.
Oh, God. Hey, I got a seat. What do we need?
You give me the Master Swordsman.
Master. That's not how you say master in Japanese.
I don't think you're going to get anything from that until the end.
Of Bushido. Learning about the spirit of the samurai seems useful, but this book looks difficult. Yeah, it's going to take me longer. All right. We did it.
Yeah.
Textbooks open to picking up from last time, we were talking about the French Revolution. Having executed the royalty, the revolutionaries proceeded to take the courts under their control. All who opposed the revolution were executed. However, the revolutionaries too were then reviled as despots and executed by the public. All in all, more than 2,900 people were executed over the course of the revolution. The fact that this many executions were possible was actually due to one specific invention. Kurusu-kun, take a look at this. It's a guillotine.
It's a what?
It's a guillotine. This device made mass executions possible. You know what it's called, yes?
I don't know why that made me think of...
So this is relevant to Haru's persona, because her persona is based off of the main antagonist from Three Musketeers, who was eventually executed by guillotine. So...
I think you mean she was executed by a wooden horse.
No. Guillotine.
This is it. Oh, you should check the network to see if...
I don't... If people were dumb enough to choose other things?
Like... Who picked by the
name
horse?
Guillotine. By the way, the name Guillotine comes from Joseph Ignace Guillotin, the doctor who proposed the idea. It may look cruel, but it delivered a swift, painless execution, regardless of one's social status. It wouldn't be an exaggeration to say that it embodied the French spirit of equality.
That shit always fucking scared the shit out of me.
Oh, guillotines? No, they're terrifying.
They're fucking terrifying.
It's just a blade that comes down, cuts your head off. And
I mean,
it?
I'm sure it's instantaneous, so it's like whatever.
It's damn near instantaneous.
But like, and fuck. Just the feeling of. Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off. Go ahead.
It's damn near instantaneous because your brain just stops getting oxygen. but it's also from what they say. I mean, who the fuck actually knows? Really, because anyone that's been used on is fucking dead. It's supposed to be painless. I don't know how that's painless, but you know, because it's damn near instantaneous. There is supposedly a split second where you can see still, so you'll actually like feel your head
plop.
Rolling. You feel your head plop into the basket. Yeah.
Yeah.
And you'll see, like, the last thing you'll see is the basket. Or whatever your head falls into.
Just like knowing, like, that this is how you're gonna die. It's like, fuck.
Oh yeah, that's gotta be terrifying. I don't know where to go.
What's today? Is it Thursday?
Thursday.
You can go to the bathhouse and get extra.
Is that open right now, or is it open at night?
Nope, it's open. Yogin Jaya.
Bathhouse? Bit early.
Damn it. Oh, okay, sorry.
You
I thought you could do it during
me.
The day.
You lied to me!
I'm a liar. You can... You can go buy games in fucking Akihabara and fucking play some games at home, get stats. Oh, yeah. Or you can go do a job, I don't know, there's fucking rando shit you can do. Look at all that Persona 4 bullshit on that screen. I thought I saw Risa just now, it might have been crazy.
That is Risa.
Oh, okay, cool. I wasn't crazy.
Yeah, that was Risa.
Man, this game has nothing on Tokyo Xana to do with its fucking references. Holy shit, dude. You don't know what a reference is until you play that game.
Well, you were going nuts with all the references.
There's so many. It's absolutely ridiculous how many fucking, how much work they put into referencing other games. It's fucking stupid.
Oh man, look at all these figures.
I wouldn't bother. There's a game shop at the end of the street. We have a game system, right?
I did buy one.
Yeah, so you can just buy like all this crap and like play some games if you want to.
Oh, it gives me stuff.
Yeah, it's stat points. It's like watching a movie or reading a book.
Okay.
No, you can go. You're not locked out of going in the to your room. This ain't Persona 4, man. It's only like sometimes it locks you out, but usually you can just go inside. Damn it. I guess today is one of those days where they don't fucking let you inside.
Mm-hmm. Let me make sure I got that retro game. Yeah, I got this set.
And the laptop. You can actually fix that laptop whenever you want.
Where?
On your desk.
Okay.
And you'll get access to a cool thing. I guess, you know, you can go do the Big Bang Burger Challenge for Guts if you want it. You can go do a job. I don't know, there's a bunch of crap. That's really all you can do at the moment.
Kindness and charm. Let's get him up. Okay, here we go.
Let me look up flower shop job Persona 5 real quick.
Larger flowers with minimal aroma.
I need to see if, like, this is still a thing where I can find.
The sweetest of peas.
What is it?
Larger flowers with minimal aroma.
Big flowers, a little scent. Gold Jibera. You passed it, it's up top. Venerable chrysanthemum.
Venerable chrysanthemum.
Whatever, dude. Shut the fuck up, you little smartass. Fluorescent freesia.
Alright.
That should be it. If this thing's not lying to me.
Yeah, thank you. Customer was extremely happy.
Alright, cool.
Here's your pay, give a little bonus, and I get some charm. Gotta get some charm. Give me kindness. I'm doing charm. Nice. Work went great today. Living surrounded by flowers might be your true calling. You were good with the customers, too. Three. Rank me up, baby. Damn it.
Damn it.
I'm getting there. We'll get there.
Wanna head back?
No.
Oh, okay, we can stay here.
We can just live in this mall for now.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, can I get Kawakami to...
Make sure to hit Kawakami this time.
Yeah.
Hi. Make sure to close up.
Thanks for doing that. Alright, I'm gonna check my plant real quick.
Sure.
And I might play a video game. Oh no, I want to go to the...
You can do the, I'm gonna do the bathhouse.
To the bathhouse.
Check your desk real quick.
Check your desk for me.
You don't have to do anything. I just want to see if it's.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, okay.
I can fix the laptop.
So you can do that. It's gonna take a night. I think just a night.
I'll do
that. Then you can do a cool thing with your laptop. So.
I will do that at some point.
I would do it like when you have all your shit mixed out.
I promise.
Because you're going to max them out before the story's over, so.
Let's go in. For 500 yen. For $5.
$5 to a fucking bath with some old dude.
To bathe with an old man. You came out of there looking, whoa. Your body is so hot.
Nice body.
I mean,
body.
Temperature-wise. Hey!
There we go. Now we can finally finish Makoto.
You know what's great?
Wanna head back?
What?
Now I have doubts about my choice. Because now I have max charm. It's fine. We're gonna keep going.
Yeah, well.
Hi. Oh, well.
I warned you.
I can do it on my second playthrough on my own time.
Hey, you said do it on.
I'm gonna do on, alright.
Anyway, I warned you, dude. That was my last choice for you. But
I think on is okay. I think she gets a bad rap, but compared to the rest of the cast, except for Oya and I think
Super.
There was one other. She is definitely not a standout.
Super Miss Potential girl.
She kind of is. She kind of has a lot of Miss Potential. She could have had a very, very interesting arc.
She could have been alright. But
I think they did. I think they already kind of pushed the envelope with the attempted suicide and then the sexual harassment with the teacher. And I don't know if they wanted to get too into the actual like
rehabilitation would have been sick though.
I know that's what we're trying to say is that they should have gone there, but they didn't. I think they didn't because they wanted. They already pushed some other aspects of the game.
I guess you can say, like, she, like, it's not Shiho's social link, so it's more of her coping with it in her own way kind of shit. But
well,
I don't know, I think it would have been better.
No, you can still have that part in there and have, have Shiho be a part of her social link. Mm-hmm. But focus more on, like, while you're watching Shiho go through rehabilitation, like, she's learning how to walk again. Just have Akira and An sitting off to the side with her in the background, you know, doing her exercises or whatever. And An and Akira are just talking about it. And she's, you know, An's talking about things that are really important to her that, things that she has to think about because they're brought up because of Shiho's situation. There's a lot of shit they could have done.
Hmm.
They could have had her, like, break down because it affected her that negatively and she had to go to Akira for, you know, for comfort. There's a lot of shit that they could have done, but they just didn't do it. And I'm kind of sad they didn't. So, we're at 8, going to 9. I would like to enter Mementos again today. I believe that place holds the truth of the human heart. Let us go.
I don't want to go in there.
Yes, sir, Matthew Mercer, sir.
I'm not
going
in there.
That was a weird glitch. Did you see that?
Yeah, that was pretty fucking weird.
This place never fails to amaze me, no matter how many times we come. Where does this passage even go? It feels as though I'm being sucked inside merely by gazing upon it. So, this is the heart of man. It is ugly, yet beautiful as well. That duality is what makes humanity such an interesting subject. As you know, I have been confused recently about the reason for my art. Did I want to be recognized, or did I want to capture pure beauty? Was it due to my talent, or just my upbringing? Each answer would seem correct at first, yet only prove itself false upon a more in-depth examination. Akira,
what are your thoughts?
When my mother was painting the Sayuri, what do you think she was thinking about?
It's one or two.
I think one. Her love for her son.
Yeah.
Such love is almost embarrassing to have pointed out to me. But you are probably right. However, I believe that was not the only thing she thought about. It seems the Sayuri was meant to impart something with me, and all others who view it for that matter. Love, regret, loneliness, anxiety, calm, and hope. All of the emotions my mother felt conveyed plainly to the viewer. That is why it has such a profoundly unique impact on those who see it. My paintings pale in comparison to such depth of meaning. How could I have hoped to convey pure beauty with my limited palette? And yet, that painting has kept me going this whole time. During particularly difficult nights, it was there to soothe my sadness. It acted almost as a ray of light cutting through the somber darkness.
How could this be?
I had wanted to create a similar beacon of hope for others, but it seems I lost sight of that goal. Look, this world is a dark, unrelenting place, Akira. But that is why I'm going to wield my brush again, to give hope to all those who see my paintings.
One.
You've really changed, Yusuke.
Yes.
Yes, thanks to you. You chose to help me work through my problems instead of leaving me to my sadness. Now, I will use my art to paint over the blackness of this world. It shall become a vivid realm full of hope. I expect it will be a most beautiful sight to behold. Perhaps you will see it someday, Akira. Painting a beautiful world.
Ranku up. Motherfucker.
All right.
Hell yeah.
I'm gonna paint.
This radiant light growing within me. It must be the light of hope. I shall paint it. I'm a paint.
I'm Picasso.
That's Yusuke Social Link is I'm a paint.
Look at me, I'm Picasso.
Look at me, I'm a regular Da Vinci.
What happened to my spaghetti?
What happened to my spaghetti? On your way home, you clearly have time on your hands, Yusuke-kun. I'm on my way to prepare for the competition. Speaking of which, do you plan on entering? Indeed, I do. Your pride may not be too pleased with the outcome. After all, the winner's spot is not simply yours for the taking. I suppose whether you ultimately opt to enter is entirely your decision, though. The more the merrier, yes?
You fucking calm down.
The winner's spot. Ah, yes. I was hoping to prove my talent to him by taking the top prize home. That no longer matters to me, though. I am going to enter my painting merely so others can be exposed to it.
See you later.
Well, I will talk to you later, Akira. Farewell.
Bye. Actually,
luck,
Ren,
Mamma
Mia.
A Mamma Mia-kun.
Ah, you're back.
A Mamma Mia walks into the house and goes, "Somebody touch a mass! Bug it!"
What a fucking dummy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Gotta get Kawakami to do the thing.
Yep.
Make sure you close up.
I need to tell you how many times I've heard those fucking sound clips.
Make sure you close up.
Every single night I do this, like when I got to this part of the game, every single night I did this shit. And I heard those sound clips so many fucking times. What is it?
I don't have the special tools.
Go to Akihabara. I didn't know you needed special tools, or I forgot.
Okay. I need to look around. They're closed.
Nah, that's fine. Go to that wrench. Oh, maybe it is closed. Alright, we'll come back. I totally forgot about that. We'll buy a laptop part tomorrow. That's probably what it's gonna be called.
Laptop part.
Go hang out with Oya or some.
Hey, I'm gonna play video games.
Okay.
It's all about Phantom Thieves. I did buy a game console. Now we can play games! Games are made up of several levels, completing one level, fill in one cartridge icon time. Okay, cool. They're like books.
Yeah.
Like you said. Let's play a game. So we got Star Fornius, Punch Ouch, Train of Life,
this fucking
Power Intuition, and Gambler Goemon, and Golfer Sarutahiko.
Goemon.
Charm, Kindness, Charm.
Charm's done. You're done with Charm.
Oh, that's right. So I need Kindness.
You need Kindness, Proficiency,
Train of Life,
and whatever the fuck else.
Listen to this music.
Okay.
Let's start up Train of Life.
You might have to do something.
Novice course. I see. Not only do the dice rolls move you forward, you can also use them to buy properties. I think things are going well right now. You could probably finish in first at this rate. Oh. Huh? There's something strange up ahead. Is that an octopus?
Be prepared to do things.
Blorp, my name is Octavius. I'll let you go if you can satisfy me, Blorp. You'll have three chances, Blorp.
Does this guy exist just to get in our way?
If you can roll my favorite secret number or higher, I'll let you pass, Blorp. You can roll the dice up to three times if you want. You'll never guess my secret number, though.
So we need to roll at least his secret number, but he didn't even give us a hint. I guess we should just try to get the highest number possible.
Well then, here's your first roll, Blorp.
Alright.
That's pretty good.
10?
Yeah.
10, Blorp. Do you want to go with this number?
Fuck that. I mean, yeah, do it. Fuck it. That's pretty high.
The highest I can get is 12. So.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think it'd be... I mean, if it's higher than that,
your
that's pretty
10, Blorp.
Up.
As for the secret number, do you remember my name, Blorp? Octavius, so 8.
That's 8. Yeah, okay.
You did it! Gorg, you've messed up my secret number trial. I guess I'll be retreating then, Blorp.
Octavius, ride the way into the sunset. Alright, let's head onward to the goal.
What a great fucking game.
Playing fucking video games with my talking cat.
I was about to say, man, wish I had a talking cat that would just sit and
this
watch
life.
You play video games.
I want this life so much, you have no idea.
That'd be the sickest
shit.
Be
able to play fucking retro video games with my fucking talking cat, are you kidding me?
You know I would- Oh, nice. Awesome. You know I would make him just sit there and watch me play Trails for 80 hours.
Yeah, he'd like it. Because he's a bro.
Learn about these characters, you fuck.
Learn about these characters so I can talk to you about them.
I have no one else to talk to.
I'll play the game eventually. Just not yet.
I know, I'm just fucking
I got Master Coffee.
Nice,
thanks,
man.
I played video games all night instead of studying. Are you proud of me? No? Alright. Bye, Mom.
Is that what you call her? Mommy?
Hell yeah, dude. I think everyone just learned something about me.
I mean, hell. Dude, if I ever get a girl, that's never gonna happen, but if I ever get a girl, I'm gonna do it once. Out of nowhere. I wanna see what happens.
Call her mommy out of nowhere and see what happens? What if she... Okay, here's the problem, though. What if your plan backfired and she looked at you and said, say it again?
I'd be down, dude. I'd be like, yeah!
Hey, guess what?
What? Oh yeah, Makoto.
Talk to Makoto.
My baby girl.
Baby. What's up?
I'd call her mommy any day of the fucking week.
Especially if she's in the queen outfit. Good lord.
Hell yeah.
Hey. No, I'm not trying to go to the fucking student council room, you idiot.
Look at you shimmy in front of her. It's fucking hilarious.
Okay.
Do you have time to spend with me?
I have charm! I have Scathic! What a good fate, waifu. We're at rank 5. Going to 6.
God, I can't believe- I forgot they put it right in the fucking middle.
Yeah!
What garbage.
Shall we go? Let's meet at the diner, as I mentioned before.
They knew this is best girl. And they're just like, yeah, don't worry. We got you.
We're gonna make you work for it. Oh my god. Look at this guy.
Do you like that
guy?
Heard
all about you two from Aiko. So, I heard you're the student council prez, Makoto-chan. I totally wish I could be one of your council members. Yes, I am. Totally. And Glasses-kun, over here is your boyfriend, yeah? Yeah. Aw, looks like you guys don't get along too good, though. Looks like your love level's rock bottom. Are you seriously dating?
3. The next two responses
next
don't
one
matter.
Is okay. Love comes in many forms.
Doesn't matter from now on.
Dude. Right! He doesn't really like it when I get all clingy with him. Oh, I get it. You just don't got any affection compared to us. Mm-hmm. Hey babe, did you go do something special today? I don't remember you looking this sexy.
fucking hate this voice.
Oh, Tsukasa! Sorry, I have to use the bathroom. Later, lovebird.
I fucking hate this.
There's something I'd like to ask you. Are you serious about pursuing a relationship with Aiko? Aha, I was wondering when our honor student was going to show her true colors. That reminds me. Aiko said you were real pumped about getting to know me. Why is that, huh? I just wanted to make sure you're good for her. Damn, girl, you really care about your friends. Good stuff. I always say, friends are like super important and shit. Speaking of which, a friend of my GF is totally a friend of mine. How about you tell me your digits? Huh? What's wrong? Come on, give me your number.
Yeah, friends are like super important and shit, dude. Holy fuck, that was the best line. The rest don't matter, so it does. So pick whatever you want.
Here, have my number instead. Nobody asked you, Glasses Coon. Anyways, Aiko already gave me yours, Mako-chan. We good. I do have one more question to ask. You're not going to bring Aiko to your club, are you? What, you suspecting me? I wouldn't dream of it. It's a damn shame people think us hosts are just flirts. But my love with Aiko is pure as snow. Don't twist the story.
Twist the story?
Is something wrong? I was just getting to know your little friend here, honey.
I fucking hate
well,
this one.
I should get going. I've got to be at work soon. Me too. Bye.
Is that just cool, Mark?
I hope he's not trucking.
No. Fuck.
But no matter what I might think, I still don't have any proof. And above all, Aiko seems really happy. Am I just getting in the way of their happiness? I don't think so. No, you're being considerate. I suppose so. I mean, I really am worried about Aiko here. In the end, I know this is just a hunch, but my father always stressed how important it is to trust hunches. Your father was a detective, right? So... Seems that host has sent me something already. What is this supposed to be saying? It's full of emojis. It's me, Tsukasa, heart emoji. I know we just met, but I couldn't wait to phone emoji you. I'm so happy to be friends with you. Mako C, clapping emoji, hot springs emoji.
Why hot springs?
That was barely a coherent sentence, but I'll need to get used to that if I'm going to help Aiko. By the way, I'm glad you were here with me. I would have really panicked had I been alone. I honestly despise how immature I can be sometimes.
Thank you very much.
But I'm working through that with your help, so thank you.
But size better, though. Fuck off, Pat. You
Kuranku. Did you see Makoto for a second there just like open her mouth like a little beep?
No, I totally missed
her. Her model.
Do a zoom in for me.
I'll try to.
It's real far away though.
We should get going too. I'll let you know if anything else comes up. Man, alright
then.
I'm sorry, Makoto. I really wanted to choose you.
You should have. It's okay. I get to see something new, so it's fine for me.
Yeah, you get to see something new.